sometimes the enabled will sort of implode and move on to another enabling relationship, right? I'm wondering about, you and I are both advocates of the importance of the attachment theory and the deep value that this relationship, the bond between the parent and the child is, you know, that it's so fundamental to the growth and the development of the brain of the developing child and adolescent, and that moves them into the capacity to have healthy relationships in adulthood. How do you reconcile having a strong bond with, say, an adolescent child, while also holding very firm bottom lines around what we're talking about and not becoming somebody who's swooping in and sort of that helicopter parent idea? Because it's sort of, that's sort of the, you know, the lingo that we use for enabling behaviors. See what I'm saying?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, for me, it goes back to, again, that whole idea that seeing them as strong and capable and able to solve their own problems and grow up and develop. And I think when we see them as weak and defenseless and pathetic, then we start treating them less than human. We start lecturing, we start controlling, we start reminding, and they feel disrespected. And and so I think that I know for me and my clinical practice and my also just my lived experience with my own kids is that when my kids feel respected by me, that means that I'm clear about what I believe they're capable of and I expect them to do it. And I don't swoop in and remind them or panic or, you know, call in other reinforcements. Mm-hmm. I just, and then I let life teach them as well. And I don't rescue them from that stuff. Yeah. And we just stay with it. So I'm in relationship the whole time, you know, I'll totally go with you to your traffic court situation and I'll be there for you, but I'll let you do the speaking but I love you. And boy, this is super hard. And, but you got it, you know, you can face this, you can do this.
I love
those kinds of things. Yeah. So I just say like, treating them like they're strong, staying in relationship with them. They feel respected.
Yeah.
And they may struggle, whatever, but they're not going to feel weak. That's for dang sure.
Right. Because we're basically handing it back over to them and saying, I am not going to overfunction for you because I believe in you. And I think the other thing that you said that I really, really like, Jeff, is to help the child really, really metabolize the truth that I'm not mad at you. I'm not angry at you because I'm holding this bottom line. And this is the same with a partner, right? This is the same thing. Another, like with an alcoholic partner who we've been tiptoeing around and organizing our whole family around somebody who has something that is getting in the way, to basically say, I have not been loving you well in not confronting this behavior. And because I love you and because I love our family, this has to change and I will no longer be doing that. Now that just requires, even as I'm saying and I'm thinking about how, when I have had occasion to do that, it is kind of terrifying. It takes an enormous amount of like sense of self and strength that it's like, I know you don't want this, but because I love you. And that is a very securely attached kind of way of relating to the person. In other words, that wouldn't engender ultimately an ambivalent or an anxious kind of attachment, because the person on the receiving side, while they may not like it initially because the gig is up, they're seeing in us strength and reliability and a sense of like, wow, she knows who she is and she's going to stand up for it because she loves us. She loves me. She loves our family. And so I think what I'm kind of making sense of as you and I are kind of exploring this together is that there's going to be an initial problem. There's going to be like the moment when we say no more, it's going to probably, it's going to not be pretty.
Absolutely.
And then maybe as we stick to it and we show this sense of depth and calm and a sense of wisdom, like I can be okay. Again, metabolizing our own anxiety around what the enabled is going to do and what all the people on the outside and how they think and how they feel and the potential judgment, like all of that, as that sort of evens out, then we really start seeing the growth and the strength of the system. And that's when things can become stronger than ever.
Thanks for stopping by and watching this little clip of my podcast interview. If you want to catch the full episode with this guest, you can click on the link below. It'll take you to my podcast and you can listen to the whole thing. Once again, I appreciate your support. I've got lots of other episodes you can check out as well. And I'd love to hear what you think about it.